If you are not well prepared, if you don't apply the knowledge that you have, then you cannot make money. You can't. Okay? You're just going to sit down there and be whining and be talking and be complaining day and night. At the end of the whole stuff, your marriage that you're actually talking about will hit the rock. Because money is part of it. Now, when you see your mate are traveling, they are going to Dubai, your mates are sending their wives all over the world, your mates, they are buying stuff for their wives and their wives is looking good, and you check out their DPs, check out their pictures on social media, see what they're wearing. I'm not saying money cannot come later in the future, but so many people are today, they are where they are today because they refuse to plan and they refuse to put effort. When we are talking about hard work, we are not talking about you going to become a bricklayer. We are not talking about you going to cut grass. We are not talking about somebody that is sweating. We are talking about you, that you are applying what you have learned. You are applying your knowledge. Applied knowledge will open doors. Applied knowledge will bring money to you. Applied knowledge will open channels of blessing unto you. It's a big time hard work to actually put something on the ground, water it and make it to grow. All right, it's a lot of work. It's a hard work. It's a hard work going to school. It's a hard work learning a trade. It's a hard work going to learn anything in life. It's a hard work. So if you refuse to put the hard work there, you are going to fail. You're going to fail. Do you want me to blame the woman that said, "Oh, I'm actually divorcing my husband because I've been drinking garri every day of my life"? Oh, I want to actually walk away from my relationship because, all right, there is nothing for me to actually say this is our home. Nothing whatsoever. And then the man is saying, you have to be patient. Be patient, be patient, be patient, be patient, be patient. How long am I going to be patient? You're only sitting down right there. You're not making any effort. No effort is being made and you believe that money is going to come to you. Money is never going to come. You're only joking. You have to apply that knowledge that you have. Applied knowledge will bring money to you. If you don't apply it, it won't. Now, one other thing I want to quickly say is this. If you are expecting money to come to you, you are applying the knowledge. Now, it's not going to be the very first day or the second day of you applying the knowledge that money will come. You have to continue to do it. You have to continue to do it like every day, every minute, every second. You have to continue doing it like every minute, every second. Continue doing it, doing it, doing it, doing it. I see Chinwe Udoze. Do you want to come on the show? Do you have something to say? Do you want to ask me a question? Let me see if she's got a question to ask me. Oh, she's gone. All right, she's gone. All right. You know what I'm saying? So you need to go through that hard work. You know, somebody was saying, even if you pray and you put hard work, you need an environment like America to be able to make it, not environment like Nigeria. Who is telling you all that? All right, who's telling you all that? Principles are principles anywhere. The same principle that works in America will work in Nigeria. You just have to create the opportunity for yourself. You just have to create the opportunity for yourself. All right? It's about you creating opportunity. I know a lot of people in Nigeria that have never been to America before, but they are well informed. It's about you being informed. It's about you knowing who you are and what you want to achieve in your life. Your location don't matter at all. Your location doesn't have anything to do about it. You can create a good location for yourself. All right? If the location is not good, you can make that location to be good for your own business. You can make that location to be good for yourself. You see, the problem we have is that we don't know exactly how to apply knowledge. We don't know how to apply knowledge. Okay? That's the problem that we have. Everybody believes that when you come to America, you make it. Do you know how many people are rocking and walking all around America without anything? A lot of Nigerians walking all around America without anything. Nothing in their pocket. Nothing to say, this is my own. Nothing whatsoever. They don't have a house. They don't have a car. They don't have nothing. They've been in America for 15, 16 years. Nothing. Nothing whatsoever. And they're just roaming around the street. And you sitting down in Nigeria that you're supposed to be putting effort. You sitting down in Nigeria that you're supposed to create opportunity. Now let me tell you this. When preparation meets opportunity, that's when the miracle is going to happen. Preparation will meet opportunity, then the miracle will happen. Okay? So if you don't have the preparation, you don't have the education, you don't have what it takes, when the opportunity will show forth, you're still going to continue to complain. And then you'll be saying his powers and principality. Oh, his powers and principality, they are not allowing me to move. Oh, his powers and principality, they are eating my future. His powers and principality, they are eating my goodness. So you don't have any goodness. There's no goodness in you at all, because you are only acquiring the knowledge. You are not applying the knowledge. You are not applying the knowledge. Do you know how many of you carry cell phone? Do you know the kind of cell phone you guys are carrying all around the place? You're talking about brand new iPhones. Brand new iPhone. That some people are having iPhone and they're making thousands like almost every week. Some people are having that same iPhone that you are carrying all around and wasting. The iPhone you are wasting. You got money to buy it and you're carrying it in your hand. And you are wasting that iPhone. And that same iPhone is making some people thousands like every week. You don't understand how to apply the knowledge. You don't even have the equipment. You don't have to understand how to use it. The opportunity is there for you to use. No. You buy your data and you waste it watching Nigerian movie. You buy your data and you waste it chatting with girls. You buy your data and waste it chatting with boys all around the place. You are wasting what you have, instead of using it to better your own self. It's not everybody that will become a doctor. Not everybody will become a lawyer. Not everybody will become a pharmacist. Whosoever God has made you to become, always make sure that you take advantage of that opportunity to better your own self. It's time for you to think in a different direction. Stop thinking about whatever. Think in the different direction that tomorrow, when you don't have anybody around, tomorrow when you don't have this job, tomorrow when you don't have this or that, how will you survive? That will be a kind of a push for your life. A push for your life to actually use whatever it is around you to be able to better yourself. It's a moment. It's a time for you to use it. Alright? Stop wasting time. A lot of you guys go to prayer meeting. All these years you've been going to the prayer meeting. Tell me what has changed in your life. Now, put your hard work plus your prayer. Now, you will see that testimonies will come. The people that you see in your church that are sharing testimony, they are not dumb like you. The people that you see in your church that are sharing testimony are not dumb like you. Those guys are spending their time going to work. Those boys are getting their time going to school. When you don't know that they're going to school, they read overnight, they wake up in the morning, they go to work, they come back, they go to class, they come back, they go to church. It's hard work. Why you are busy saying, you will become doctor or prayer warrior. That's what you will become. Prayer warrior doctor. That's what you will become in your life. Nothing for you. Nothing. Like Belagino, I my revelation. That's what you now start thinking about. Those boys that are actually coming to church to come and beat the drums, those boys coming in to play the keyboard, they go to school during the day. They work at night. They go to school during the day, they work at night. They just don't come to church alone. All those women that you see that come to church, they come and pray, and then they go home. They go to work, they go to school. They graduate from school. After graduating from school, they become somebody in life. Then they come and give testimony. And you are sitting down there, and whenever they give testimony, you believe that maybe your prayer is not enough. Maybe you have not been praying enough. Then you start praying again. Ah, Baba, oh. Oh, you are my baby. Baba, my baby, na. Oh, you are silent. Dabukumle. Baba, oh. Silent. I want you to come away. We idiot, lele. Idiot, usijaku, jaku. Or de ran. Or de usijaku, jaku. They will not be looking at you. There is principles that work here on earth and principles that cannot work. Alright, you are not in heaven yet, you are on earth. There are so many things that you need to understand about this world that you live in. Alright, that will actually bring prosperity to you, that will bring prosperity to knock on your door. Alright, those are the things that you need to go and learn. You have to stop being over spiritual. I'll be talking about what power and principality holding you down. Nothing is holding you down. You are the power and principality holding yourself. You are the enemy of your life. You are the one. You refuse to do what other people are doing. Alright, you refuse to go to do whatever they want you to do, and you are expecting miracles to happen to you. It's never going to happen. It's never going to happen. You're going to stay there for a long time. You don't understand that people come to church to come and share fake testimonies. You don't know. A lot of people, they share fake testimonies. They come to